are entering into the time now where it's Thanksgiving. It's a beautiful day here in northern Michigan today, and there's just so many things to be thankful for. And as we enter into this Thanksgiving and Christmas season, I want to read you a few verses that talks about thankfulness. The first one, I want to start in Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 10. It says, "When you have eaten and are full, thank God." I thank God that I don't have to forage for food. And that's not true for everyone in the world today. It's not even true for everyone in our own country today. So I think in that sense, our Thanksgiving attitude, our thankfulness, needs to also produce a compassion, which in turn will produce an action on our part as believers, that we should support local food ministries, food banks, food pantries, and we should help out and lend a helping hand whenever we can. "When you have eaten and are full, then you shall bless the Lord your God for the good land which he has given you." Isn't that awesome? Don't forget where you got your blessings. When you're eating, man, you're full, give thanks to God. In Psalm 100, verse 4, it says this, "Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise." Now, we could say it this way. Don't go to church saying, "Man, I wonder what the pastor's going to preach this week." Don't go to church into his courts, in through those gates, with a bad attitude. Go to church with a thankful heart to the Lord that you're saved, that you're filled with his Spirit, that you're blessed, that you're prosperous in Jesus' name, that you're living an abundant life of joy and love and peace. And the gates and the courts is not just church, of course, we know that. When you go before him in prayer, begin your time of prayer by offering thanks to him. The latter part of that verse in Psalm 100, verse 4 says, "Be thankful to him and bless his name." So when we go to prayer, you know, a lot of times, and I've been guilty of this, and I'm sure many of you have too, you know, we start right off just praying about, "Oh God, help me, oh God, help me, oh God, I'm desperate, oh God, I need this and I need that." But I think we should start our time of prayer by thanking him and blessing his name for all the good that he's done in our lives, for what he's done in our hearts, for what he's done in our families, for everything that God has blessed us with. That's how we enter into his gates and in his courts. It can be it's the church, but it's also your prayer life. In Psalm 107, verse 22, it says, "Let them sacrifice the sacrifices of thanksgiving." Sometimes it's a sacrifice because of the pain in your life, the pain of what you're going through, the struggle that you're in. Sometimes it's a sacrifice to just go on ahead and give him thanks anyway. But oh, how he blesses us when we do that. And it says, "Declare his works with rejoicing." You know, we should be rejoicing every day, saying, you know, "Thank you, Lord God. I am so happy that somewhere, somebody got saved today. Somebody got brought into the kingdom today. Oh, somewhere today, Lord God, because of that $20 that you allowed me to give, that you blessed me with to give, Lord, somewhere a child was fed today. Oh, I'm so happy." See, it says, rejoice in his works. And what it helps do, and what Thanksgiving helps do, is take the focus off of me. And it takes the focus off those troubles I'm having and those problems and difficulties I'm going through. And it puts my focus on the God who is bigger than the problem. You see, my God, the God that I serve, ladies and gentlemen, is bigger than my problems. It doesn't mean I don't have problems, but God is bigger. Let's read another one. Let them sacrifice the sacrifice of thanksgiving. Sometimes it can be tough. And declare his works with rejoicing. And then in Colossians 1:12, it says, "Giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us." Wow. You know, we got a whole lot of people running the earth today trying to qualify themselves for whatever. You know, a lot of people say this just refers to salvation. No, it doesn't. you can't qualify yourself for salvation. You can't qualify yourself for any good gift of God. You cannot qualify yourself for any ministry. You must be qualified by the Holy Spirit. How does that happen? It happens by being a yielded, obedient, and willing steward of the manifold grace of God that He's entrusted to your life. And as He sees that, and a lot of times people wonder why they don't advance. They don't advance because they haven't allowed God to put the right foundation under them. So it's not fit to build upon a foundation that's faulty, because it'll cause you problems later. So He wants to get that foundation right. And then once that foundation is right, once that focus is God instead of self, once that attitude is right, once that heart is right and functioning the way the Holy Spirit is in control of it, then God begins to build upon the proper foundation in our lives. Hey, I know what I'm talking about, man. I spun my wheels for years learning these very things right here. Learning how to be thankful when I didn't feel thankful. Learning how to be content where I was before God promoted me. You know, a lot of people just try to promote themselves, try to qualify themselves. But listen to this. Giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. And so every single one of us have been qualified by the Father because of our faith in Jesus Christ to partake in the blessings of the kingdom and to partake in eternal life. Eternal life. Glory to God. In Colossians 2:7 it says, "We are rooted and built up in Him and established in the faith as you have been taught, abounding in it," abounding in the faith, "abounding in that which you are rooted and grounded in with thanksgiving." Praise God. So it all comes back around full circle. Everything I have, Lord, you've given it to me. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the wisdom from the Word that you give me. Thank you so much for the funds that you give me to be able to build camps and to feed hungry children and to give Bibles. Thank you, God. It's all you. It's not me. It's God's grace that He gave me these things. Now, I'm a steward of it. I could keep it for myself if I want to. But I would bring the displeasure of God. I would bring even the curse of God upon my life in some fashions. Somebody says, well, we're in the New Testament and under grace. We're not under any curse. No, listen, obedience always brings blessing. Even under grace, even in the New Testament, obedience always brings blessing. So I take the blessing that originated with God anyway, and I give Him thanks for it. And then I say, God, what do you want me to do with it? How do you want me to steward this blessing? And I let the Lord call the shots, so to speak. And if I'm willing and obedient, then that is a blessing attractor. It's like a magnet. Obedience is a blessing magnet. Thanksgiving is a blessing magnet. And God just begins to pour out in our lives. Finally, in Colossians 3:15, it says, "And let the peace of God rule in your hearts." Now, what that means in the original language, it means this: let the peace of God be your umpire. Let the peace of God call the shots in your hearts, to which also you were called in one body. You need to be in a church somewhere, hallelujah, flowing and functioning as community. And then it says, and be thankful. And be thankful. Glory to God. And then in 1 Thessalonians 5:18 it says, "In everything," in everything. Doesn't say for everything. Let's answer this question right now, because I know many of you have it. Well, I got in a car wreck the other day, Brother Paxton. Should I thank God for that? No. God's not the author of car wrecks. Well, my friend has cancer. Should I thank God for that? Should he thank God for that? No, God's not the author of that cancer. Doesn't say for the bad things. I don't thank God for cancer. I don't thank God for car wrecks. I don't thank God for tornadoes and cyclones and hurricanes. I don't thank God for depression. I don't thank God for poverty throughout the world. No, not for it. It says, in everything, give thanks. And that means that no matter what position I find myself in, no matter what circumstance I find myself in, I'm going to give thanks to God because He is a good God. He is worthy of my praise, and He gave His Son that I might have eternal life. And so in everything, give thanks. I want to read that again. And I'm going to have Angie put it up on the screen, all of these verses, of course, but this is 1 Thessalonians 5:18. In everything, give thanks. And kind of the understood subject of that statement would be this. In everything, there is something thankworthy that we can grab a hold of. You see, because I told you a moment ago, Thanksgiving is a blessing magnet. Okay? So in everything, no matter how good or how bad, there's something thankworthy that we can grab a hold of that might just be our key, might just be our ticket up out of a bad situation. And if not, at least we're obeying the command of Scripture to give Him thanks for His goodness. He's a good God. You say, well, you know, somebody that I loved got sick and died. Yeah, but He's a good God. And God knows things that we don't know. And God has answers that we don't have. But somewhere in the midst of that, you can find something to give Him thanks for, because He's a good God. He's a good God. He is worthy to be praised. So in everything, there is something thankworthy. So give Him thanks. And then it says, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Now let me wrap up this little Thanksgiving talk this way. Every one of us are going to face a journey called life. And none of us know at the beginning exactly where that journey is going to take us. We usually can only see the part of the road that we're on right now. And maybe just a little bit ahead. And sometimes the Holy Spirit will warn us or reveal some things that are ahead. And sometimes, as in my own case right now, the Lord will even have us to look back for certain reasons, to teach us what He wants to teach us. But we're all on a journey called life. And the will of God in Christ Jesus for me, for you, as we walk through this life, is to give Him thanks in everything. That's what the Scripture said. That's 1 Thessalonians 5:18. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. So that means, if I'm having a good day, I give Him thanks. If I'm having a bad day, I give Him thanks. You say, well, you make it sound like it should just be so easy. No, it's not easy. Remember, we read, sometimes there's a sacrifice of thanksgiving. But as we begin to allow the Holy Spirit to order our life that way, and you're talking, I mean, you're listening to someone talk who, I'll tell you, I grew up a very negative person and a very much a complaining person. And so I understand the struggle that can be involved in this, but as you allow the Holy Spirit to restructure your life that way, in everything, give thanks. And just become a thankful person. Thankful for what you do have, rather than envious of what you don't have. Thankful for the blessing that comes into other people's lives, instead of being jealous that you don't get it. Thankful for what God has made out of your life, and the promises that He's given for your life to make you more. Be thankful. Be thankful, because that's His will for us. None of us have the complete roadmap, and we don't know what we're going to face tomorrow. The only way we know is in those moments of the gifts of the Spirit, when God chooses to reveal something to us. But we do have His Word. We have His guidance. We have the Holy Spirit to help us. So this Thanksgiving, I want to encourage you. I don't know what's going on in your life, and I know this much, God loves you, and God cares about what's going on in your life. And just for that very fact alone, why don't you take the time to thank Him today? Thank Him for His goodness. Thank Him for what He's blessed you with. Thank Him for the prayers He's answered and will answer in your life. And develop, just tell the Lord. Some of you might need to just say, God, please develop a thankful heart in me. Because I have a hard time finding things to be thankful for. And some people really are in serious problems. But just whisper that prayer today. God, help me to find something today to be thankful for. I believe, neighbor, that if you'll do that, it'll turn your life around. And God will reveal Himself to you in ways that will absolutely blow your mind. And I believe God has a good plan for your life, irrespective of your circumstance. So, this Thanksgiving, when you say Happy Thanksgiving to a family member or a friend, you can really mean it. Be a thankful person. This is Evangelist Len Paxton saying, go with God, and He will go with you. Bless you.